Our coffee breaks with researchers aim to spread knowledge about regional development and innovation. By sending a camera around the world, we present you with different angles and insights on the topic. We ask researchers directly and in a personal manner about their work. We want to make scientific knowledge accessible to all. Hi, welcome to Coffee Break with Researchers. Today, I'm having a coffee break with Cristina Chaminade. She is a professor at the Department of Economic History at Lund University in Sweden, and she's also an expert in globalization of innovation. Hello, Cristina. Thank you for accepting my invitation to my coffee breaks. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, Lorena. Thank you for inviting me.
Today, I'm having a black coffee from Indonesia. Which one are you having?
Oh, I'm having a super nice Arabica 100% coffee from Costa Rica. Very nice and very soft.
That's very nice indeed. I will definitely need to try that one. I was just reading one of your recent papers, the one about the global innovation of networks in firms, and in which you analyze if these networks depend on the location of firms. This is an empirical paper, which was very interesting for me. I would like to know from your words what the paper was about.
Yeah, in the paper we are comparing the propensity of companies located in different regions to go global. So we are really looking at how the regional context in which they are located affects the way that they engage globally in the search of knowledge, for example, for innovation.
And which one was your main finding?
Well, I mean, I can tell you what we were expecting. We were expecting that companies that were located in very strong regions, like capital regions or regions that are very diversified, that those were the companies that would go more often globally because they were strong companies, basically, or multinational companies. And rather than that, what we found is that it was companies that were located in regions that were neither too peripheral, not too strong, were the ones that were engaging more in different types of global innovation networks. So it was telling us something about the capacity to go global and at the same time the necessity to go global. So both needed to be hand in hand.
And did you have any specific challenge in doing the empirical part?
Yes, actually, I mean, every time that you work with developing countries, there is a very big challenge in finding the data. So finding data at the regional level for Bangalore and for Beijing was actually quite a big challenge in this paper. And it was also quite a challenge to try to capture the degree of thickness of the region. So which indicators to use to say that one region is very thick and another region is thin, for example. So that was a major challenge in the paper.
And I guess this challenge can also be motivation in doing a research like that. Did you have also personal motivation in doing it?
Yeah, I'm very interested in this international comparative analysis, and I'm very interested in processes of transformation of regions in developing countries. So those are regions and companies that are located in regions that are usually not so well developed, where there is quite a limited amount of resources, and they really need to go abroad to gather the knowledge that they need to innovate. So understanding these processes of transformation in developing countries is really a personal driver. I'm very interested in that.
I can copy to that. Coming from Colombia, a developing country, therefore this is a very interesting topic for me. Could you please tell me a policy implication for policy making in developing countries?
Yes, one very important policy implication is regarding this balance of having the capacity and having the need. So usually companies that are located in regions in developing countries, they have the need to go abroad because they don't have the resources in the regional innovation system in which they are located. So they use these international networks as a kind of compensation mechanism, but sometimes they do not have the capacity to go abroad. So policies is very important that they focus both on sustaining this capacity building or capability building in companies and at the same time helping them to go abroad to, for example, participate in international innovation fairs or help them to participate in international research collaboration projects. So this support for internationalization and capacity building is really, really important in firms in developing countries.
And is any of these findings a future path for you for doing research?
Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely very interested in researching this interplay between regional dynamics and global networks. Right now I'm more looking at transformations towards sustainability and again, what is the interplay between this regional endowment, basically, and global international network. So I will continue working in this field in the following years.
That sounds very exciting. I'm very much looking forward to your next paper. And thank you, Cristina, for joining me in this coffee break. And I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, thank you.
Thank you for watching. If you are interested in more details about this research, find here the link to the academic publication. Bye.